Get ready to have your mind blown by a discovery that's shaking the very foundation of space exploration. Voyager 1, the intrepid spacecraft launched by NASA 45 years ago, has just revealed a terrifying finding that's leaving scientists and enthusiasts alike gasping in awe. And here's the kicker. This daring mission is communicating this groundbreaking discovery from billions of miles away using technology that's more outdated than a Walkman. But that's not all. This shocking revelation is rewriting everything we thought we knew about the universe, and its implications for humanity are nothing short of earth-shattering. So what could Voyager 1 have uncovered in the depths of the cosmos that's sending shockwaves through the entire scientific community? If you're as excited about this discovery as we are, hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more mind-blowing content that will take you to the edge of the universe and back. In 1965, something miraculous happened. A NASA scientist, Gary Flandreau, came up with an incredible idea to explore Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune using a special technique that would take advantage of a rare cosmic event. This event, where all four gas giants would align, is an incredibly rare occurrence that happens only once every 175 years. This phenomenon is called a grand tour alignment, where Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune align in such a way that a spacecraft traveling through them can use the gravity of each planet as a gravitational slingshot to increase its speed and change its trajectory. Flandreau also calculated that a journey from Earth to Neptune, which would have taken 30 years, would now be accomplished in just 12 years, thanks to these gravity assists. After this amazing discovery, NASA scientists and engineers started working on deep space exploration missions. The opportunity to use the gravity of multiple planets to propel a spacecraft on a grand tour of our outer solar system was too good to pass up. The alignment also presented a unique chance to study each of the gas giants and their moons up close. The Voyager missions were specifically designed to take advantage of this alignment. With the launch of Voyager 1 in 1977 and Voyager 2 a few weeks later, NASA was able to send two spacecraft on a grand tour of our outer solar system, with each spacecraft visiting different planets and moons along the way. This alignment allowed the Voyagers to make a series of flybys, where each spacecraft used the gravity of one planet to slingshot itself towards the next, ultimately leading them on a journey to the outer reaches of our solar system. The alignment was a critical factor in the success of the Voyager missions. Without it, the spacecraft would not have been able to travel as far as they did, nor would they have been able to visit as many planets and moons. The alignment also allowed the Voyagers to send back a wealth of scientific data about the gas giants and their moons, revolutionizing our understanding of our solar system and beyond. Despite being designed for only 4 years, the Voyager probes have gone on to shatter all records in the history of space missions. And over 45 years later, they are still going strong, sending back groundbreaking information from the farthest reaches of our solar system on a daily basis. The Voyager's epic journey began with a gravity assist from Venus, a maneuver never before attempted by spacecraft on their way to Mercury, making them true trailblazers. However, it wasn't an easy feat, and multiple attempts were needed to get it right. The first leg of their journey to Jupiter took them to a distance 10 times farther from Earth than Mercury, and they had to navigate through the treacherous asteroid belt, a topic of much debate and speculation beforehand. Both Voyagers have 3.7-meter radio dishes and 16 thrusters to help point them in the right direction for communicating with Earth. Its thermoelectric generators are powered by plutonium, and their hydrazine fuels their engines. Each contains 11 scientific instruments on board, although they are no longer in use. Right now, NASA's Voyager 1 is going into deep space on a dangerous and unknown journey. It is the farthest human-made object from Earth. It is about 14.6 billion miles away, and it and its sister ship, Voyager 2, are the only ones that have made it out of the solar system and into the space between the stars. When you're that far away, anything can go wrong. Now, before we talk about the terrifying part, let's rewind and see Voyager 1 and its epic journey through outer space. It all began in April 1978, when Voyager 1 was about 165 million miles away from Jupiter. The spacecraft began to take some stunning pictures of the planet. By January 1979, Voyager 1 sent back pictures that showed Jupiter's atmosphere was more turbulent than when Pioneer flew by in 1973 and 1974. In January 1979, Voyager 1 started to take a picture every 96 seconds for 100 hours. These pictures were used to create a color time-lapse movie that shows Jupiter turning 10 times. Can you imagine that? On February 10th, 1979, Voyager 1 entered the system of moons around Jupiter. In early March, it found a thin ring going around Jupiter, which was less than 19 miles thick. Then in March 1979, Voyager 1 came within about 174,000 miles of Jupiter. After that, it came close to several of Jupiter's moons, including Amalthea, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. The spacecraft also found two new moons, Thebe and Metis. After Voyager 1 met Jupiter, on April 9, 1979, it made its first course correction to get ready for its meeting with Saturn. A second change, made on October 10, 1979, made sure that the spacecraft wouldn't hit Titan, one of Saturn's moons. In November of the same year, Voyager 1 flew by the Saturn system again, and it was just as amazing as the first time. The spacecraft took pictures of Saturn's moons, Titan, Mimas, Enceladus, Tethys, Dione, and Rhea as it flew by. From the information that was coming in, it looked like all of the moons were mostly made of water ice. After meeting Saturn, Voyager 1 left the solar system at a speed of about 3.5 AU, or astronomical units per year. This spacecraft was 35 degrees north of the ecliptic plane and in the general direction of the Sun's motion in relation to nearby stars. Because of the specific needs of the Titan flyby, the spacecraft was not sent to Uranus and Neptune. On February 14, 1990, Voyager 1 took a series of backward-facing pictures, which captured about 60 images of the Sun and planets. This was the first ever portrait of our solar system as seen from outside. When the spacecraft took the pictures, it was about 40 AU from the Sun, which is equivalent to 3.7 billion miles away. Throughout its journey, Voyager 1 took a total of 67,000 pictures, and these were the last ones. The crew turned off their cameras to save power and memory for the mission to another star. All of the encounters with planets ended in 1989, and the missions of Voyager 1 and 2 became part of the Voyager Interstellar Mission, VIM, which started on January 1, 1990. The goal of this new mission was to expand NASA's study of the solar system beyond the area around the outer planets, all the way to the edge of the Sun's influence, and maybe even further. Finally, in August 2012, Voyager 1 became the first spacecraft to cross into interstellar space. Interstellar space is where the solar wind phenomena give way and is a more accessible front. This is where the heliopause, the border between our solar system and interstellar space, marks the beginning of uncharted territory. Initially, estimates of the heliopause's distance before the voyage of probes reached it were inconsistent, assuming it to be around 50 astronomical units, AU. The mission's funding was increased. However, as the spacecraft departed this landmark, no expected silence of interstellar transit was detected, leaving scientists perplexed. One of the anticipated indicators of crossing into interstellar space was an abrupt increase in galactic cosmic rays, high-energy particles expelled from supernovae and other cosmic cataclysms at nearly the speed of light. However, most low-energy cosmic rays are deflected by the massive magnetic shield created by the heliosphere, which protects our inner solar system from the majority of external threats. The Voyager team also kept a close eye on any changes in the dominant magnetic field. As the spacecraft ventured further, the interstellar medium, composed of ionized gases and influenced by nearby stars, was expected to have a different magnetic field orientation compared to the heliosphere. Yet the voyages reported no such alterations, adding to the mystery. So in 2012, Voyager 1 finally crossed the heliopause and transmitted back intriguing data. While it did confirm the expected increase in plasma density, there is no indication of a shift in the ambient magnetic field's direction. This was unexpected, as it was assumed that a change in magnetic field direction would occur when transitioning from a region where the Sun's magnetic field prevailed to one influenced by other stars. In November 2018, Voyager 2 arrived at the heliopause, 120 AU from Earth, the same distance reached by its twin 6 years prior. However, what puzzled scientists was that Voyager 2 detected no changes in the magnetic field, as per the theoretical models, adding yet another enigma to the mix. According to predictions, the heliosphere, influenced by the Sun's 11-year cycle, should have ebbed and flowed, just like solar wind. However, none of the existing models could explain this discrepancy, as the solar wind was at its strongest when Voyager 2 arrived, suggesting that the heliopause should have been farther out than 120 AU. As the Voyager probes venture closer to the interstellar medium, their data reveals intriguing small-scale changes near the heliopause, influenced by the heliosphere's interactions. Yet at vast scales, the magnetic field shows negligible variation, raising questions about whether the spacecraft will eventually leave these turbulent shores behind and encounter the true interstellar magnetic field, or if the current understanding of the simulation is entirely off the mark. Some academics speculate that the Voyagers may still be within the heliosphere, while others are convinced by the significant increase in galactic cosmic rays and plasma density detected by the probes, pointing towards the majority opinion. Solving one of the most fundamental puzzles about the heliosphere is akin to trying to see a goldfish bowl from the perspective of the fish. We need an interstellar probe to shed light on it from the outside. However, while some technologies like answering machines, BCRs, and pennies have become obsolete, the Voyagers continue to defy odds with their outdated, yet resilient technology. So what is your favorite discovery made by Voyager so far? Share in the comments below. Also, like, subscribe, and if you enjoy our content, check this one out.